Alright, this video is going to go over what are common causes for shifts in the IS or LM curves in our IS-LM model. So we have our IS-LM model with GDP on the x-axis, the interest rate on the y-axis, downward sloping IS curve, upward sloping LM curve. So let's look at the IS curve. The IS curve shows every equilibrium point where investment and savings are in equilibrium. So as long as our GDP equation stays the same, then this IS curve shows that equilibrium relationship. So if the interest rate goes down, GDP needs to go up in order to keep investment and savings in equilibrium. So that makes sense. But if any of these guys change, then we're going to see a shift in this IS curve to compensate for that change. So first we can start with consumers. Consumption spending can change if consumers decide to save more or save less, so the marginal propensity to consume changes. If consumers decide to save less, then we see an increase or a rightward shift in the IS curve, because at any given interest rate, GDP needs to be larger in order to keep things in equilibrium. Or at any given GDP level, the interest rate needs to be higher in order to motivate that savings. However, if consumers decide to save more, then we see a decrease in the IS curve because the interest rate needs to be lower to pump that money back into the system to decrease the amount that consumers are saving. Now, investment can change if the base investment level of firms, so not dependent on the interest rate, but the base investment level changes and it increases, then we're going to see this rightward shift in the IS curve. If it decreases, we'll see a leftward shift, and that can do with positive or negative expectations about the future. So positive expectations about the future will increase IS, negative expectations will decrease it. Government spending can play a role. Expansionary government policy will increase the IS curve or shift it right, while contractionary government policy, say raising taxes or lowering government spending, is going to decrease the IS curve or shift it left. And finally, we have net exports. So generally with net exports, if exports increase for any reason, but generally due to currency depreciation or the rest of the world getting richer, we see this IS curve shift right. Because exports are going up, makes this more positive, makes Y more positive. If exports go down because the currency is getting stronger or the rest of the world is getting poorer, then we see this leftward shift or decrease in the IS curve. And note that imports are generally dependent on Y. So we don't usually see a change in imports affecting this IS curve. But depending on your instructor or textbook, it's possible. So just keep that in mind. Next, we'll look at possible shifts in the LM curve. All right, possible shifts in the LM curve will occur due to changes in our LM equation. So here we see money supply over the price level equal to liquidity preference for money, or money demand, which depends on GDP and the interest rate. So Y and I changing is already endogenous in the model, so we don't have to worry about this side. What will shift the LM curve is a change in this money supply or a change in the price level. So if the central bank or the Federal Reserve decides to increase the money supply by buying T-bills, that's going to shift the LM curve to the right. So money supply going up is going to shift this guy to the right, and it's saying that at any given interest rate, we're going to have a higher level of GDP in order to keep the money market in equilibrium. Now, if the Federal Reserve or the central bank decreases the money supply, say by selling T-bills, then that LM curve shifts left because we see a decrease in money supply, or this M, and that results in a leftward shift of the LM curve. Now, what can also happen is we can see a change in transaction technologies or the velocity of money or something like credit cards. Now, this doesn't change the physical money supply, but it makes the real money supply go up. So if you have access to credit cards, you can actually spend money that you don't have. So the real amount of money, or the virtual amount of money, or the money available in the economy has gone up, even though the physical amount of money hasn't changed. So that sort of technological change will increase or shift right the LM curve, because there's more money available to consumers even though the physical amount hasn't changed. And finally, what if the price level changes? So if the price goes up, since this is in the denominator, we're going to have to see a decrease in this money demand, which is going to be a decrease in our LM curve, or a shift to the left. If generally prices go down, we're going to see an increase in this real money supply, and so the demand for money is going to have to increase, and we see this rightward shift in the LM curve. And so those are the common shifts that you'll see with the IS and the LM curves. Generally, if you recognize those things, then you'll have a pretty good understanding of what's going on in the model.